I like to show you how an embedded pushdown automaton processes an input string. One small note before I start. This is a buff. It may sound strange, but it's just how it is. We will start with our configuration in our initial state Q0. We have the symbol that looks like somehow like a double cross. This is the border of our stacks because this automaton can have several stacks. And we start with a stack where we have our bottom symbol on it. Then we have an empty string that's the part of the input we've already read. And in this moment we haven't read anything. And here it's what's left to read, and in this moment it's the whole input string. Now let's just make it a little bit colorful. In this moment I have something like a pointer, and it always points to our topmost symbol on our topmost stack, so in this case on our bottom symbol. And I can, in Q0, I can only now use this transition. And I will get a new configuration from it. So I'm drawing this symbol. It means something like this can be, the new configuration can be derived from our old configuration. We are staying in Q0, as this part tells us. Now, we are consuming our input symbol. Let's just some words about this part. So this nearly leftmost part tells us we are about to open a new stack below our current stack. So we are opening a new stack here. And this part consists of operations we are doing on our current stack. So our current stack is the one with the bottom symbol. And this one says we are consuming our bottom symbol. And this one says we are putting back our bottom symbol and putting a B onto it. And here in the rightmost part, it would tell us to open a new stack on top of our current stack. And if that happens, then our pointer moves to those just created stack. And the three operations are performed from left to right. So I will first include a new stack below us, then perform operations on our current stack, and then I will add a new stack on top and move to it, if that happens. So now I read 1A from our input. And this is what's left to read. Now, in the next situation, I can read an A and from the input and a B from the stack, or I can read nothing from the input and a B from the stack. But with this transition, I will processing the A in the input, and I can't do it afterwards, so I will just show you the successful trace. That means, and for that reason, I'm proceeding with this transition. So I will get a new configuration where I stay in Q0. I will create a new stack below my stack, so this is the one I'm keeping from here. And now this is the one I'm creating because of this, what's here. And then I'm on our stack we are currently working on it. And I'm reading the B from those stack, and I'm putting back a B and another B. Now I have read 2A from the input, because here I consumed an A from the input. And I have 2Bs, 2Cs and 2Ds left to read. And now I read my boots. Ace, and I can't use any of those two transitions anymore. So I will now proceed with the next transition, which is, this is the only transition possible at the moment. So I'm moving to Q1. I'm keeping my stacks, which I have here. I will consume a B from the input string and I will put it back, so nothing changes here. And also, because I'm not reading anything, this here also stays the same. Now I can use this transition. So I'm reading a B from my input string. I'm staying in Q1. I'm sticking with my D stacks. And in here I'm creating a new C stack below my current stack. Now this is the stack I'm currently working on. And as you see, I'm consuming a B from the stack and I don't put anything back onto my current stack. So I'm just left with one B here. Then I've read two A's and a B. And I have another B and this all those left to read. And now I'm doing the same again. Staying in Q1. Here are my D stacks and my C stack I already have. Then I'm creating a new C stack here, a new stack with a single C on it. Then I'm consuming the B and I'm not putting it back, so I'm left with the seller bottom symbol on my stack. And now I read two A's and two B's, and that's what's left. Now I can use this transition. I'm moving to Q2. I stick with all my stacks. Well, nearly. Because this tells me to consume the bottom symbol from my topmost stack. And now if a stack is empty, it's completely removed. So I won't write those border symbol either. That's everything now I'm left with. Now in Q2, I can take care of reading my C's. I will stay in Q2. I'm left with my D stacks and also with one C stack, because now my pointer is on the topmost stack on the C, and this one tells me to consume a C from the input and a C from my stack. So if I consume a C from this stack, the stack is empty and it's just completely removed. And now I read a new C. And then I'm doing the same again. I'm consuming the C from the stack, so this stack is completely removed. And I read both of the two C's. And then I can use this transition where I move to Q3. I will read the D from my stack and I will just immediately put it back so it doesn't change anything. And this The stuff here also stays the same. Now I can use this transition. I'm staying in Q3. I copy one of those D stacks. Then the transition tells me that I consume 1D from the input string and 1D from the stack. So this stack, which has nothing left on it, is completely removed. And now I read one of the D's. Now I have to scroll down a little bit. Now I will do the same again. So now I'm consuming the D from the stack. I have no stack left, so my list of stacks is empty. And I've read the complete input string. And there's nothing left to read, so here's epsilon. And now, if my list of stacks is completely empty and I have nothing left to read, that means the word is accepted by the automaton and the processing of the input string was successful.